Yo, Ebro.
DJ Khaled is on Ebro in the morning. Laura Styles and Rosenberg.
Guess
yes,
what tomorrow is?
What? Talk about it.
It's the biggest album in the game. It's 12 o'clock midnight. What's tomorrow? They seeing this tomorrow? It's whatever.
It's right now. It's
right
forever.
Now. It's the biggest album in the game, my brother. The biggest album in the game. 8 albums in. Who has done it better than me? Nobody. I back up any talk. I got catalog. I got hit records, man. You know who this is. It's DJ Khaled. The Don Dada. Biggest in the game. We the best music, another one. No, another two.
I heard about that.
You know, just drop two singles at the same time. What is it, smoothie?
I got smoothies on deck. You want to,
yo, talk about that smoothie,
that's what I'm about to, because what I'm saying is that finger licking, you need to get one of them mystery drinks.
What's in a mystery drink?
Laura Styles, I want to say something. By the way, those are beautiful headphones, and I want you to know this today. This is going to be your biggest interview you ever interviewed in your whole career.
In my entire career.
I'm just keeping it honest.
Now, Khaled,
some would say this, bow down and kneel to greatness. So I answer your question already. I got the answer. That's what they, whatever they would say, whatever the interview, because that's what y'all do, tell them to bow down and kneel to greatness.
Well,
they ain't never do what I do. They wish they could do what I do.
Yo, Khaled, just give us one thing.
Talk to me.
Just hit us with the
another
one. And you're a liar. We need y'all.
Oh no,
liar.
The liar gonna come out when y'all lie. Because you know y'all lie. You know, hey, y'all my brothers now. You know, but y'all lie sometimes. But it's all love. I get it. And I'm gonna let you know
when we lie.
You a liar.
So, okay. Would I be lying if I said that interview that we did with you and Saif that day when y'all had a come to Jesus meeting
it's
as friends?
Classic.
You hear about it a lot. Do people say it?
Of course, it's a classic. It's a soundbite to everybody else's radio show. That's what we provide. You know what I'm saying? When you get DJ Khaled, you get sound bites. You get documentaries. My interviews will play 10 years from now. I ain't regular like these other people. This is DJ Khaled. This is Special Cloth Alert. What you don't know?
I told you he's in a zone though
special
today.
Special cloth.
I mean, let's keep it honest. This
we might
special
as well.
Cloth alert. You know what I'm saying? It's DJ Khaled, man. Top 97. Good morning.
Good morning, Khaled. I changed a lot. You know what I'm saying? It's
the
out.
The album is out.
I'm in rare form right now, man, because I work so hard. So hard. And the album is out now, and you notice I never do y'all morning show. Not in a disrespectful way.
Yeah, no, you don't.
I really don't like doing morning show.
Khaled, I felt disrespected.
And that's why I'm here. That's why I'm here.
Your peoples was like, yo, Ebro's starting to look at us funny.
Nah, and I made it clear to my people, like, yo, put Ebro on the team. I got to do the morning show. They family. They've been down with me from day one. I really don't like doing morning shows because morning shows are built to, how can I say?
Controversy?
I mean, it's not even about, because I could deal with anything. I got the answer for everything. This is DJ Khaled.
Fact.
You know what I'm saying? I'm blessed.
But you're always about the music.
Yeah, I'm about the music.
And the morning shows tend to be about the bullshit.
But we can talk about whatever. I'm cool with it. But I'm just letting you know, this will be the biggest interview you ever had, the most views you ever had on this camera.
In our life.
Of course. It's DJ Khaled, man.
How dare you?
They've been waiting for this.
Yo, the form you're in, I've been watching this whole thing. The process was long towards this album.
Yeah.
And it's
purposely.
So you talk about that. Because I thought it was maybe to come 6 months, 8 months ago, and
because,
it's taking time.
Because you, not you, because I like you, Rosenberg. I rock with Rosenberg.
I appreciate that.
No, I respect his craft. You know, I watch his gram from the 45.
And can I
you
bring
know,
something
I love
up
what
too?
He does.
Can I bring something up too? Because Khaled, you're Palestinian.
Yes.
And Rosenberg, you're Jewish. You guys
peace.
Often, and we've tried to bring together
peace in the
you
Middle
guys
East.
Showing that hip hop brings that together.
See that right there? You see that?
That's big. That's a big picture right there.
That's real life.
And that's love. But the answer to your question is I took a long time on purpose. I could have dropped my album anytime. I'm fully loaded. I'm war ready at all times.
Of course.
I have so many records that in my drive, trust me, anybody act up, I let one go. Now listen, the reason why I took longer than I usually do, I did it on purpose. I'm tired of dinosaur shit. I'm tired of way people do rollouts and rules and regulations. I never followed a rule and regulation. The door has never been open for me to walk in my whole career. Why I'm gonna follow any type of protocol? I've never was accepted like that. I was determined, passionately ripped doors down, took the hinges off, and put the hinges in the fuckboys' hands when they try to stop DJ Khaled. So what I did was I put out more hit records. I challenged radio. I challenged the game. Let me give you They Don't Love You No More featuring Jigga. Jigga. You know what I'm saying?
Not just Hov. Yeah, it's Jigga.
Don't Play Yourself featuring Jigga. You know what's up. The guy we all love. The guy we respect. The guy that holds the rock up. The guy that we inspired by. DJ Khaled featuring Jigga. Okay? That was the, hey, remember me? You
I'm
know what
here.
I'm saying? Yep. Then I drop Hold You Down, a.k.a. number one record in the country. Number one in the country, called Plaque on the Wall, R-A-A. You ever heard of that? Certified, not the fake plaques that people just make. No, the one that says R-A-A.
Isn't it R-I-A-A?
R-A, excuse me, R-A, whatever.
Fuck all Billboard. The letters, man. You don't need
them. Fuck all that.
Then drop How Many Times, top 10 record in the country, soon to be gold, right? Now I come with two singles, Gold Slugs and You Mine. You already know what that is. And then I tell them the album's coming out. It's called Appreciating the Fan, Appreciating the Listener. It's not about the industry. It's not about us, how we care, how things get rolled the fuck out. It's about them people in the streets that love our music. It's about exciting them. I excite my fans. I know they get excited when I drop two singles at one time, two videos at one time, and boom, two ads at one time, two number one across the country at one time. And then I tell them the album's coming out. They excited. They ready to hear the body of work. What I'm trying to tell you is, what you want me to do? Drop a single and promote the album for 6 months with a date and drain out and do 100 interviews, and then when the album come out, you're bored? I ain't trying to do that, man. It's called excitement, and that's what the people want, is excitement. And I care about the listeners, the fans, the supporters. I'm grateful. I understand why I'm here. I'm here because of them. I'm rich because of them. I'm on Hot 97 because of them. Remember that. Another one.
That's DJ Khaled.
I changed a lot in stores now.
Go get it.
Is it pronounced properly? I changed a lot? Because it really, we always thought it was, I changed. A lot.
You need the pause.
You smart. Matter of fact, you a genius.
No.
Because you did that perfect.
I was practicing.
I'm proud of y'all, man.
Speaking of smart.
That means y'all rock with me. I like that.
Speaking of smart, we got to get into it, Khaled, because you work on a lot of music. You work on a lot of MMG music.
Absolutely.
Meek Mill yesterday.
Shout out to Meek Mill.
Went on his Instagram, got emotional, and he's catching some heat from it, whether he gives a fuck or not, because of what Wale said in the Breakfast Club interview about Meek Mill brought a pencil to a gunfight with regard to the Drake situation.
I think,
let me finish. From the Meek Mill situation, as fans, we have wanted Meek Mill music, and you work on music. That is what
Absolutely.
You do behind the scenes. A lot of people know that you A&R a lot of projects.
Absolutely.
What is the hold up on Meek Mill music?
They ain't no hold up. You know what I'm saying? I know Meek very well. He's in the studio recording all the time, and Meek Mill's a great artist. Every artist have a vision of how they want to promote their music, present their music. Like I just explained to you how I wanted to introduce my album. Every artist have a different vision. Kanye West has a weird, special way of vision of dropping it. And when I say weird, I don't mean disrespectful.
Just different.
I'm talking about different. And that's the word I'm using. And I love it. Kanye, one of my favorite artists. Jay-Z got a special way of dropping his music. Drake got a special way of dropping his music. Rosé, we all do. Everybody has a way. And I think music is a feeling. You wake up in the morning, sometimes you change the rollout that you plan. I know I have. You know what I'm saying? I was going to drop my album last year at this time. I stopped myself. I'm like, nah, that's the trick. That's what I'm supposed to do of the industry rules. Nah, I ain't doing that. I'm giving my fans more music. And if I got to make them wait, I promise you the wait was worth it. You see what I'm saying? Now, when you drop something and they expect something to drop and you drop something later, it shuts all the talk down. Because it was worth it. It's called quality music, my brother. That's all it is. You can't question Meek Mills. Meek Mills is dope. You had him on the show. Y'all praise him all the time.
Yeah.
What, you gonna not praise him today?
Not at all.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, making an example.
But some of his fans are feeling like he's doing this Twitter fingers, this jumping on IG, just
let's not say Twitter people. We went on the radio today.
No, I said
today.
Some of his fans.
No, us too.
Us as fans.
Us included, we're like, enough with the Instagram, let's keep it to music. That is how a lot of people felt.
I think my personal and opinions to me don't matter. And I'm going to give you my opinion. You don't have to like it. You could like it. I don't think his fans feel that way. Mm. I think his fans ride with him, just like my fans ride with me. That's what fans are for. When you ride with somebody, even if they right or wrong, you got to ride. If Ebro's wrong, and matter of fact, I'm going to use Ebro as an example.
He's often wrong.
No, not about him being wrong. This station, if somebody did something wrong, if you did something wrong tomorrow, he riding for you.
He's done it before.
Flex is riding for you. I see it all the time. Mm-hmm. And trust me, you've been wrong. You might have been wrong. He might have been wrong. She might have been wrong. But guess what the team going to do?
Ride.
We're going to ride.
But, okay.
You see what I'm saying?
And we had this conversation today because even when Meek Mill didn't give Funk Flex the record and had us all looking bad, we rode with Flex, but we were honest with the fans, right? That was our fault. We take responsibility for that, but we don't have control because Meek said to Flex, he was giving a record, it didn't come through. We got to take that L. We took the L. We took the whatever people wanted to say, socials, et cetera, right? Rosenberg, Nicki Minaj, right? I rode with Rosenberg, right? Did I chastise him? Yes. Did I chastise
him
in public?
I'm sure behind the
scenes. No, and in public.
But you still represented like, yo, it's our dog. And guess what? He's still on Hot 97.
Yeah, he's still with us. But see what Meek Mill. But see what Wale. But
with
Wale. But with Wale and Meek Mill, Wale says he brought a pencil to a gunfight. We talking about music. We talking about rap beef. Meek Mill jumps up and goes, "Now you out of MMG."
Well, this is what I have to say about that. That's MMG, right? And I'm gonna tell you something right now. If you don't know, I'm MMG. Rick Ross is We the Best. Ross is MMG. I'm We the Best MMG. Meaning as what the example I'm trying to tell you is that we're family.
Right.
When it come down with Ross and Khaled, that's when I say loyalty on another level. And the reason why I said We the Best MMG, it's one team, one family. Meaning as in my brother represents my brand like no other. And I represent his brand like no other. And the reason why I'm telling you this, that's a family. You know what I'm saying? And if it's a situation that gets on these mics and somebody talks and not agree on something, man, that's a family. Just know tomorrow morning it's all good.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because, and if it's not, you know, a big brother gonna step in and make it all good. That's how it's supposed to be done. It's called family. You know what I'm saying? And we got to respect family. And it's not even just about rap music. Think about your personal cousin or your family, your brother and sister. We all say something. That's what brothers do.
Yeah.
That's what bosses do. And bosses come and fix that. You know what I'm saying? That's just life. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day is, guess what they talking about? Success.
Well, that's what we said this morning.
You know
too,
what I'm saying? We're talking about success.
We're still talking about MMG, which is why Ross right. is like, that's family. We good.
That's right. And that's why I love Ross, because at the end of the day is he not gonna fall for the hype. You know what I'm saying? And he gonna come in like a boss and say, SMMG, don't ever disrespect the empire. In DJ Khaled's word, another one. You see what I'm saying? That's what he said on his gram. That's I woke up seeing that. I expected that. I ain't call him. I know what he gonna do because that's a boss. That's a real friend. You know what I'm saying? I ain't talk to Meek or Wale about the situation. I don't need to. For what? We got money to get.
But do you ever call and say, let's make these songs, though?
Of course.
While this shit is being talked about, yeah. I got this record for you, Meek. What's popping?
I mean, you know, anytime I call Meek for a record, it's done right away. You know what I'm saying? I never had a situation where it wasn't. And if it wasn't done right away, ain't no problem. You know what I'm saying? It'll get done later. And if it don't want to get it done, it's still cool. You know what I'm saying? I respect people's vibes, energy. And that's why people respect DJ Khaled. I wouldn't be who I am if I was just...
I need this.
Yeah,
I need.
It's not about I need. It's called... Don't get it twisted. If I call you and I ask you to get on a record, that might help you.
Evidence suggests it does. No, those records have helped a lot of people.
No, and the same way that it helps me.
Right.
It depends on what situation. And that's why I always look at every opportunity presented to me. I always overthink the opportunity in a good way because it's an opportunity. And I never want to mess up an opportunity. Like, for instance, I got an opportunity to come to this morning show. For me not to come over here, that's why I told you, that'd be crazy if I don't show up. or, you know, if they wanted me up here and I don't come and I can make it that day. I gotta come because it's an opportunity and it's a platform that y'all giving me to play my music, to promote my album, and to have fun. You know what I'm saying? And for the listeners to see another side of Cali they've never seen. I'm sure they've seen a lot today they've never seen. Because they always see me on Billboard or they see me on the network.
Or they just hear your voice.
Yeah, and they don't get a chance to hear the personality of me or Ebro asking some intelligent questions or you asking me some intelligent questions or Laura Styles asking me questions. I get a chance to wear my headphones. That's being nationally promoted right now. By the way, in stores, online, right now.
And you know, Khaled.
You see what I'm saying? Like,
so what are those headphones called again?
86 with DJ Khaled. We the best sound. We the best edition. Lamb skin leather, you see the gold quality, exactly. The craftsmanship,
I'm a big fan.
And the quality of the sound, it's a vibe.
It's a very good sound, Khaled. You showed, I always knew you were a real DJ. It was reinforced when I heard how the headphones sounded. You did a nice
It took a long time. You know, I could have put the headphone out a lot quicker, but it took a long time because I wanted it to sound a certain way. And if you notice, like when you put it on an iPhone, it's a certain level, but when you put it right here, You know, that with an amp, you can control the volume on another level, but it's still quality when you turn it up super loud.
Right.
So my sound is accurate. It's a real sound, and I made sure of that.
You said your sound was...
I don't know how to say these words right.
That's a classic. That's going to be a classic. Accurate is out of here forever.
See, y'all going to catch me on these memes.
And while we're on it, though, you do have Khaled classic lines.
Yes, absolutely.
I'd like to call them Khaled quotables.
Thank you.
Another one.
Big talk.
I've changed.
A major talk.
A lie.
Just know.
You're a liar.
Big talk.
Now that's
a liar.
It's own shit. Now we've learned accurate. Yeah.
Don't forget, say my name.
Yeah, say my name. You smart, of course.
You loyal.
You a genius. Don't play yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself.
And these are words that just come out naturally.
Now, Kyle, I'm going to ask you something right now. This is an important question. The most important question I'm going to ask you all day. You know, we talk about this all the time with you. You know that you are a character in hip hop. You're very revered. You're very loved, and you're very amusing. Like, you make people laugh, right? People smile.
I'm just being me.
That's what I'm saying. How aware are you that you make people laugh?
Well, God has blessed me because I know that I've been put on this earth to make people happy and inspire people and uplift people. That's a beautiful thing. But the only downfall about it is that I really don't have nobody do that for me. But it makes me super strong. You know what I'm saying? Because I do know that even if I'm having a bad day, I can come up here and I can make Ebro and y'all laugh and smile. You know what I'm saying? And y'all love my energy. And I'm so grateful for that because that's a blessing.
Yeah.
That people that actually want you around and like your vibe, especially when it come down to making music. So imagine how the artists feel when they recording with me because y'all have to see me in the studio.
I can't imagine that energy.
It's crazy. Let me tell you something because especially if it's one of my records and I see a vision that they might not see yet.
I can't. That picture?
And I'm painting it, and I'm letting it explain the whole movie, and I'm explaining the whole year, actually. Besides the record, I'm telling them what's going to happen, when it's going to happen, how it's going to happen, and the end results is called Billboard Plaques. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it always happens. I want you to know, throughout my whole career, from the beginning of my career to right now, DJ Khaled, for 10 years straight, has hung up a plaque from every record, every project I've dropped off of albums.
How many number ones you got?
I mean, I got 2 to 3 number ones, right? I got like 100 top fives and like 100 top tens. I'm definitely in the Billboard family. You know what I'm saying?
They know you. They know your address well.
My plaques, I have every single, like say if I drop 3 singles off an album or 2 singles or 1 single, guaranteed 1 or 2 singles off each album is went platinum or gold or triple platinum. You know what I'm saying? All of them. I haven't missed yet. I told Ebro this the other day, I haven't missed yet, and I'm going to remind people, this is what I do. You know what I'm saying? And there's nobody better than me when it comes down to doing what I do. I don't act like nobody. I don't sound like nobody. I'm DJ Khaled. talent.
What's that cloth you cut from?
Special cloth alert. Big bezel alert. Pinky ring. It's special cloth. Look at the fabrics I'm wearing today.
It's luxurious.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Yeah. It's always special cloth that could do this. You know, special cloth is Jigga, Biggie, Tupac, Premier, Pete Rock, Ebro, Laura Stout, y'all are, Rosenberg, y'all are special cloth.
Thank you.
This other morning shows, but is it this one?
No. It's not.
Okay, so that's what I'm trying to tell you. We have to embrace our greatness. What you waiting on to embrace it? The other day I heard you talking to Source Magazine. Where the fuck is Rosenberg at? On the top 30. Fuck your magazine. That's what you should have told people. Fuck your magazine. Because where's DJ Khaled on the covers of all magazines? Why they ain't praised DJ Khaled yet? But see, when I was growing up, and I was respecting the game, and I was inspired from Puff Daddy, that I'm inspired to this day, that's my friend, they're going to praise him. They're going to praise Dr. Dre because he is great, he is amazing, and he deserves it. They're going to praise Quincy Jones. They're going to praise Barry Gordon. Why? Because they deserve it. But what about me? I don't deserve it? I don't have the fucking catalog of fucking wins? Fuck your magazine. Bow down and kneel to greatness. The magazines mean nothing. They out of tune. They dinosaurs. Fuck your nominations, too. Yes, I've won plenty of awards. You go to my house, you see 4, 5, 6 BET awards guaranteed. You see awards from the local awards to the BMI awards, number one, the Billboard. I get awards all the time. What, you stop giving awards because I keep winning? Are you crazy? I ain't stopping. How you don't give Khaled best collaboration? Who the fuck puts better collaborations than DJ Khaled? You tell me right now, Ebro. You tell me. Tell me, you tell me why Hold You Down or all my other records ain't get no collaborate. You tell me if you so in tune into the fucking culture. All this weak shit, soft shit, industry controls the votes. Fuck that. The people supposed to control the votes. Keep it real with yourself. Keep it honest with the fans. The fans don't know this. They expect us to have fucking rings and trophies because we deserve it. I'm one of the best in the world, man. When Michael Jordan wins all the time, he one of the best. Why? Because he is.
Facts.
I'm talking truth and facts, Ebro. I ain't lying to you. I ain't lying. Tell me when I'm lying. Stop me. Interrupt me.
I will. I would.
I've been sitting here thinking. I wanted to throw out a name just so I could hear you go, you're a liar. But I couldn't even come up with one.
You can't. Shout out DJ Nasty in the building. Nasty, you ain't never seen me like this, right?
I like it. I like it. You talking that talk?
No, because you know what? And don't get twisted. I got love for magazines. no, because right now I got the cover of Complex coming out. Thank you.
Complex is good.
I like Complex.
Fader's good.
There's right. Well, Fader hasn't gave me the cover.
They haven't.
I'm confused. And I know the people over there, and I like them. And right. And they some hip hop people.
Rob
they
Stone
are.
And them.
And
yeah.
You know, those are good people. They
Cornerstone.
My, they my family. They my friends. I'm confused though.
Because you're a DJ. Because they're DJ.
That's what I'm saying. How the fuck you ain't got DJ Khaled? One of the best DJs in the world, and you know it. And you know it. Matter of fact, you know my story.
Oh, very well. They know you from coming up to the conventions.
They
and
know
doing
me
all
from the fucking mud. From the mud. From I've been down from the mud. I was there.
Running up to get drops from artists and
there.
Shit.
I was there when Biggie, when the fight broke out. I was there.
Howard Homecoming.
I was there when Karis went through the tennis ball and you grabbed the tennis ball. I was there. I was DJing at these shits. I was DJing everywhere in the street. I'm one of the best in the game. How the fuck you ain't giving me the cover? I don't care about the cover. No, let me tell you why. Let me tell you why I'm so
Talk
passionate
about
it.
It. Talk
it's
about
because,
it.
You know what? I thought about it the other day. I'm such a great guy. I respect everybody's wins. I get excited. I hang these shits up in my room. Like, my shit is like, I'm hip-hop.
You celebrate.
Yeah,
yes.
Right. I'm celebrating. And they deserve it. I would never say they don't deserve it. I'm talking about the people that run these magazines. They're confused. They're in an AC room. They're never in the streets. They're never in the mud. They might have used to be. They think they know what's going on in today's time. They're liars. They need to hire somebody beside them so they can continue being the boss. Real bosses have a team of people that is going to inform them and keep it real so they can be in tune to go check it out. And makes the boss look good at the round table. That's how bosses work. Because you got to be a boss. Sometimes you got to stay behind the scenes and make the power plays. You don't give DJ Khaled the cover. Do you know my story? Are you serious? Do you know what I, you know the shit I go through? I risk my life every day to do this shit. And you don't acknowledge my greatness? And these people are tripping, man. These people, all they tripping. And they can take it anyway because I'm war ready. I'm war ready. My music speaks for itself. I put music out. Music is powerful. Nobody can stop hit records. You, Laura Styles can say, Ebro can say right now, don't play this DJ Khaled record. We don't fuck with him. It can't stop it. I'm not saying he would ever do that.
Never would.
I know that. He supported me from day one in my career. And matter of fact, helped me a lot in my career. I've been on Summer Jam. He believed in my vision and let me go on stage and bring out one of the best Summer fucking Jam moments in history.
Ebro?
A few times.
Okay, okay, no. I'm just keeping it real. I'm just keeping it real. You got Jigga, then you got DJ Khaled on Summer Jam. I don't care what you say. I seen all the tapes. I watched them. I seen the crowd move. I seen the energy.
Which is your favorite one that you did on Summer Jam? What's your favorite
one? The one when we broke BMF.
Woo!
That one, when I brought Cameron out, Barrington Levy, it was just what they call a special vibe. You know how Ebro strict on that stage.
Woo!
You know that?
I know, I've seen it.
He allowed Different the person. Ruckus because he knew. He yeah, had I goosebumps.
I remember.
You know, goosebumps. Because Ebro usually will, you won't even have an opportunity to come with a crowd.
No, that night. I came night, with 100 people. I remember the crowd. No. That was the night, Ebro, that me and Syf said, fuck it, and we ran on the stage too.
Yeah, yeah. But see, Ebro felt the energy backstage.
He did. He couldn't be stopped.
He felt the energy backstage, and that was a moment in my career. And the newspaper, what's y'all's newspaper? New York Times?
Yeah.
They put it front page, am I correct?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the picture of
John,
you.
Shout to John Caramonica.
John Caramonica, you're smart. You should have been the fucking editor of these fucking magazines. See how quick you put me on the cover? You see what I'm saying?
I don't know if he did that, but yes, they got it right.
Whoever his boss was,
they got it right. They got it right.
He wrote a. Thank you. He got it right. Why Fader ain't put DJ Khaled on the cover? Why Double XL ain't put me on the cover? They have put me on with the regime of Miami Movement. I will give them that. But come on, it's been 10 years. You ain't support. You ain't showing me no love. What the fuck you waiting for? You want to write about? Waiting for me to do something wrong to write about? Man, come on, bro. Man, give the fans what, you know, embrace greatness, man. Inspire the next DJ Khaled.
Inspire
the young world, the kings and queens. Inspire them, man.
When you're talking about these incredible moments and the accolades that you rightfully deserve, a few weeks ago, the New England Patriots opened their season, and when they do it, they come out with All I Do Is Win. Talk about the level of
Rosenberg,
that.
Rosenberg, I make the biggest records in the game. Rosenberg. Did you know Obama walked out to my record?
That's right. Yes, that's right.
The president that we all voted for, that we love, I don't know Obama. I feel like I know him. You know why? Because he's great. These fucking magazines, some of these people know my story, and they don't embrace me. Their kids listen to my music. They listen to my music and sing it word for word. Why you hating on me? You ain't got love for me?
Here we go.
No, I'm just, wait, you see, now I know, you understand these type of music I make. When I made They Don't Love You No More, it was a reason why I made They Don't Love You No More. That's how Khaled. I was feeling. That's so I went and got Jigga. I got Jay-Z, man. Who gets Jay-Z?
Only you.
Ebro, you know this.
I know.
He can't get him.
I can't get him. You
should get him.
Khaled, what was that conversation like when you called Jigga? Can you
first of all, Jigga's my friend.
Yeah.
He don't have to do a verse for me. That's my friend. I appreciate his relationship. I'm grateful to know him. And that's somebody that I am inspired by. So if I'm in a room with him, I always tell him, thank you for your time. He embraces greatness. He's a real dude. I'm speaking from experience. And I'm a fan. I'm not scared to tell somebody I like their music and I'm a fan. That's why we make music, to have fans. You're number one because you have fans. You have listeners. That's what we do it for. That's all I'm saying, my brother. I know y'all think I'm tripping tonight.
No, but we don't.
Listen, I bugged out just like you are right now. Say, you've seen me bug out.
Yeah, no, trust me. You can go bad sometimes.
Sometimes it's required.
I tell him all the time, I got to watch Ebro. I don't know, is he cool today? Like,
you never know.
What's the energy on him? At least I know this because I respect what he does. You see what I'm saying?
But having passion for your work and having passion for people respecting work, I think oftentimes is lost on people who aren't striving for greatness. There's a lot of people who strive to just be in the game.
Right.
There's a lot of people who just, I don't even know what they do.
They want, they strive to have popularity and fame. I strive to be blessed and have greatness and have a long career.
Mm-hmm.
And we all been in the, we had this conversation the other day, we've been in this game for a minute. We bless, my brother. Mm-hmm. Rosenberg, you've been in this game for a minute. Laura Stout, congratulations.
Thank you.
You're a new generation of success. God bless you. After you do this morning show, I'm sure one day you're going to be doing the afternoon show. God bless you. Keep working. That's how it works. That's how it works. Ebro, you've been doing this for a long time, right? Why? Because we're winners. There's people that can't make it past their first record. There's people that can't make it past their first air shift. They can't make it through their contracts. Do you understand that? We have. We overcome all odds. We overcome all regimes that come in. Every corporation has a regime that comes in every 3 to 5 years. Always know you will be fired. And those that make it through the storm, just know you great. And when you make it through the storm and you great, you become a boss if you're smart. And you build your own brand and you create your own empire. When you leave here, you're still big. You're still doing your thing. You're still getting money. And you're still getting praised by the people that you left. Because they respect you. That's what you call being great. Longevity. Don't worry about your first week sales. Worry about your fucking 10 years of your career. Some of these artists got it confused. Y'all don't work hard enough. I got people coming to me talking about I work. Work. Boy, I ain't have Instagram. I ain't have Twitter. I ain't have Worldstar when I came in the game. I had the word of the mouth. I had, when I came in New York, Funk Flex and Cypher and Ebro let me on the radio and let me DJ for 30 minutes. And guess what? I woke the fucking city up. People recorded that show. To this day, they talk about it. I went to Brooklyn at the Omni. They changed that name so many times. I'm DJing the club. They got fucking Rottweilers in the club with bats as security. I'm risking my life to get my name out. The club owner told me, I'll never forget in Brooklyn. This 10 years, this longer than this 15 years ago. This is when DMX came out. And the owner of the club said, Calgary, do not play no DMX. I look around, this man must be crazy. I DJ in the club, first thing I did was play 10 DMXs. The biggest fights broke out, it was a riot. I understand why he said it now. But guess what? I wouldn't stop. They said, you see that boy DJ Khaled? We didn't have Instagram or a blog for them to see it. But the word of mouth in the streets talked about it. That's how I came up. Going city to city on pirate radio, you know, of his, giving a beat CD, whatever. That's how it came up. You heard that boy Khaled? That boy Khaled crazy. That boy Khaled got a talk game. That boy Khaled rips any club down. That's how these new artists, they got Instagram, they got the morning show, that the minute the interview's done, it's on the motherfucking internet. The biggest promotion. So you got the outlet to be great, and you out here thinking you cool? Y'all crazy. When that shit over, you broke. Not me. Anybody been to Finger Licking yet? What I'm trying to tell you is,
what,
how you like my headphones?
How the headphones go?
Amazing. Let me tell you
They're
something.
They're great. The lambskin.
They sound
They're
listen, what lambskin. I'm trying to tell you is, my music has blessed me because I have a career. I could retire tonight. I'm great. You still going to be screaming DJ Khaled. You still going to be hearing my, I'm recurrent records all day.
They keep playing.
They
keep
playing.
That's what they call it in the business, recurrence. That's what he has lots of.
They reoccur.
That's what I'm trying to tell you is that I'm great. All I do is win, gets licensed every single day. You ever heard of Theo Setemeyer? It's my lawyer.
I've heard. He's a very big lawyer. Probably the biggest in the business.
Biggest in the game. What I'm trying to tell you is, every day he emails me, do you approve this movie? Do you approve this sports channel? Of course I do.
Of course
I do. I'm not the guy that's denying nothing.
No, that sounds
good. So, Callie, can we have a brief producer talk?
Can't wait.
My God.
Can't take that.
There's confusion. Oftentimes in hip-hop, because you have people who program beats,
right,
who think they're producers.
Yeah,
some of them. You have people who can play instruments.
Absolutely.
Who think they're producers.
Right.
And then there are people who are producers that can also do all of those things.
Right.
And then there are people who are producers that can't do any of those things, but they know how to make a hit song.
Right.
You, sir, can program the beats.
I know how to program beats. I know how to produce the full thing, you know what I'm saying? And now,
all the way to the mix down, to the arrangement, to
everything. Now, don't get it twisted, I have a team, and I praise my team. I'm not like these other guys that hide their team. That's why I always promote, and I give them credits on all my records.
Who is your team?
I got Lee on the beats. I got Nasty Beat Makers. He produced All I Do Is Win with me.
Congratulations.
He grew up with me from day one. I used to make beats in his garage. Nasty can tell you right now, I'm nasty on the MPC, nasty on the turntables. So is he.
Do you believe in that confusion, right?
Because Ben Billions, the Runners, I got a lot of team. But
Quincy Jones didn't, I don't believe, played an instrument on Thriller.
So basically,
but he organized everyone.
Basically, this is what it is, right? A producer gets the job done and makes the record come to light, and 90% of the creative process, because on my records, I can speak for my records, that's all my vibes. From like picking, if I pick a beat, sometimes I hear a beat, I just hear the melody, I make them, I change the drums, I need the drums, I hate them, let's do new drums. If it's writing, it might be me and a writer come up with, you mine, that's my talk, you mine, that's my talk that I sing in the shower to my lady. Like, you understand what I'm trying to tell you? These are things, and I come to artists and I present to the artists ideas. Every record has a different story. So I come with the artist an idea, and they either love it, and if they love it, they contribute to it, they make it 10 times bigger. Producers get the job done. If it's from getting a beat maker with you in there, sometimes I got to call a guitarist in, a keyboard player in. Sometimes I got to call a guy that plays the flute. I tell them sometimes what to play out my mouth. I wanted to go, that's producing. It's getting played. You know what I'm saying? That's writing. You know what I'm saying? That's putting a masterpiece together. Let me ask you this. If it was that easy, how come these people can't make the records I make? The artists that saw my records always want the records for themselves. That's how great they are. You see what I'm saying? And you ever want a hit record, come to me. I'll give you one. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to come to me and you experience the We the Best sound vibration. Every record has a situation. When I started in the game, I was a full beat maker. Beat Novocaine. That's when I made the records for Joe Crack, Ludacris, Fabulous. You know what I'm saying? Ask these people, they see me actually, you know,
program,
sample. You know, that was when I was in the Beat Novocaine era. I had a sound, it was real dramatic, you know what I'm saying, with hard drums and a lot of synths. That was my sound. The bigger I got, you know what I'm saying, when the game changed, like with No More Vinyl, they had Serato. Well, producing changed. They made Logic. They made Fruity Loops. It's called Too Easy. It's called You Tell the Computer What to Program. That's why you see everybody as a producer and a DJ now. But it takes a great producer like me to tell them sounds is garbage. They're fake. Don't fall for the trap. Let's go with these sounds. Let's do this. Oh, shit, this beat you presented me is dope. Give me that. Watch what I do. Reformat it, you know, put the artists on it, put the ideas on it. Boom. I'm not taking your producer credit. We produce this together now. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a real dude. Some people hide them. I don't.
Do you believe, and the reason I took you down that journey,
yeah,
do you believe that lack of understanding in the game is...
They don't know what you do.
No, of course, the new generation.
Or these people who sleep on you, the cats who don't give you the credit, they don't understand what you do.
And that's why I'm on, and that's why Ebro's bringing this up to answer questions. That's him being a great jock. And he knows, because I think Ebro produces too. I seen Ebro in the studio. You know, everybody, some people are just special and gifted. Like, I'm a super great A&R too. I'm a super great executive too. You know why artists love me? Because I'm an artist and I also know the game on the business. I make records. I make records. I find records. I put records out. I'm a machine. You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Not everybody can do them three steps.
No.
Some people can just be the artist.
Yeah.
I can put it out for you. Ebro knows, you know. I have meetings here all the time. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? It's called being a boss. Like, you know, people, you know, I'm not gonna come in here unless the groundwork is done. I'm not crazy. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of artists is not educated. And that's what I mean. I came up in a special cloth alert time. You see what I'm saying?
Khaled.
Yes, sir.
Quotables.
Biggest in the game.
You smart.
Big.
You loyal.
Loyal.
Huge.
Khaled, when you said to that girl in the video, say my name, and she says back to you, did that car. Did you say, yeah, you said my name, but not quite right?
No, listen, so let me tell you what happened. It's so crazy because we shooting a video in L.A. And I'm telling Gil Green I need some beautiful girls because I have an idea that I want to talk to a girl intimate. So she got to be beautiful. So he had a bunch of girls on the set. No disrespect to them. You know, we picked and they were pretty. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, this is DJ Khaled. We got to do this big. Right? So we quickly find him through Instagrams, and Instagrams are liars too. Jesus. That Instagram is a liar, man. So, no, it's the most lying thing I've ever seen in my life.
With
the, I don't know what y'all do. From the side, take a picture and it looks amazing. Then you meet him in person, you're like, what the fuck? That make us that powerful? Now, I've never seen nothing like it in my life.
I know. It's just bonkers. Crazy. No, it's bonkers.
It's crazy. No,
an iPhone is like
crazy.
A computer. You can edit everything. No, I've seen women edit the shit.
I never knew what makeup was till Instagram.
But it's not even makeup, Khaled. It's like you have filters. It's a baby Photoshop in there.
They shouldn't do that because they're going to be met in person one day.
I know. It's crazy. I know.
So boom. The problem is, so.
So you find some girls on Instagram.
We found her on Instagram. She flew in, like, that night. We picked her. And she's a pretty girl, you know what I'm saying? You know, I don't know her. I met her on set.
Right, of course.
So when I said, say my name, and she said a name like that, I was like, this girl can't speak English, I don't think. No, I got love for her.
And
no,
of course.
I know.
No, I want to make sure, because I would never disrespect. Because she's a superstar now. And what I'm saying is, I like this, though. Because it's like shows the worldness in me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, DJ Khaled, I'm like, I like that. Because she might be Arabic, Spanish.
We don't know. You can't quite tell.
We don't know.
I don't know. Right? But I'm like, that's dope. This is going to be dope. And the thing is that, you know, this wasn't like a practice run. I just took it. You know, it was like 1-2 takes.
Did you know people would respond to it strongly?
I knew it was going to be exciting. I didn't know that was going to take it to that next level.
We took it, and every time the song played,
we would play the audio.
And
we
go, ZZ,
Did that happen?
Yeah.
Yo, man, listen. He's changed.
That's right.
A lot.
The album is out right now. Features include,
man, Jay-Z, Lil Wayne, Chris Brown, Future, Rick Ross, Big Sean, John Legend, Jadakiss, Future, Yo Gotti, French Montana, Meek Millie, Trick Daddy, Ace Hood, Mavado. The list goes on. Featuring your favorite artists.